Good morning. I'm outside Barking Station, a major station in East London with connections to many lines, and frankly, it needs some renovation to bring some fresh changes to the old architecture. And guess what? That's exactly what C2C is doing here at the station. So here's all you need to know about the Barking Station upgrade. So as we approach the station, it's very clearly seen that the old facade is in dire need of replacement, and that is happening. As well as this, all of the glazing is being replaced, giving the station a fresh new look, which continues all the way inside. There is now a brand new ticket hall on the left side of the station, which recently opened after many months of construction, with new ticket machines, a ticket office, 8 passenger information displays, as well as a gate line with one wide aisle ticket barrier. The site of the original ticket hall has been closed off as they are renovating it. Once this is ready for customers and opens, boarding time will speed up massively and overcrowding in rush hour will be reduced. However, the old retail units that used to be here, which have since been demolished, are not returning. But space is being made on the left and right sides of the ticket hall for new large retail units, one of which will most likely be a small supermarket. All of these changes to the ticket hall are meant to recreate the original intent of it back when it was built in 1959 to the designs of H.H. Powell. This is what the flow of passengers looked like in the original design. This is the flow of passengers from a couple of months ago when there were still kiosks. And this is what the flow will look like when the works are complete. We really need to take our hats off to this very talented architect. As we go through the ticket barriers, here is the next part of the project, which will help C2C and TfL a lot. At the moment, during construction, to gain access to the lift, which provides step-free access, passengers have to manoeuvre through these black hoardings.
Doors opening.
Right, so the lift is being moved so that it will be inside of the gate line when the renovations finish, so that fare evading will diminish inside the station, which was a big problem when the lift was outside of the gate and lots of people evaded fares using the lift. Up on the roof of the station, many solar panels have been installed, which C2C predicts to generate half of the electricity needed for the station, bringing Barking into a greener future. If we go onto the platform, we now see that the kiosk spaces on different platforms have been rented out to become cafes, which look very nice. And the building on platforms 1 and 2 will be repurposed as a passenger toilet, a space for British Transport Police and facilities for staff, replacing the space used upstairs in the concourse, which used to take up a lot of room. And apparently, this old network southeast signage, which is dotted around the station, was meant to be given away to charity a long time ago, but it is still here, as far as I can see. So you can take a step back in time to when all the railway lines, which are currently on the overground, were operated by different railway companies. Right, so I am here in the subway at Barking Station, which connects all of the platforms. One of the improvements is to promote local artwork from local artists and local schools by putting it up here in the subway. And I think this is a very nice thing to show off what this amazing community can do. So that is a general overview of the improvements here at Barking Station. Thanks for watching. Press subscribe and like. Have a good day. Bye.